Good evening, everyone, and thank you, Professor Shomnath Roy Choudhury, for this opportunity for bringing Tamishra on board, one of our very own, very dear student, of whom we are very, very proud of. So she had been 2018 pass out, topper of her batch, and I believe Shomnath has already been writing a short CV of her while he has been sending out this notification. So apart from that, she has been the first girl student who participated in the hackathon of 2017. She was only in third year. Remaining teammates were from final year, I think. So that's when we found her not only a good student but a very dynamic one, and she has some all-round capabilities. Most of it, I believe, soft skill is one of her strong points. So something which is very much essential in today's career, in the world that we are going to be in. So it's a good opportunity now today that the juniors are going to have an opportunity to interact with her. She's going to speak about, now that she has joined another institute, a very prestigious one, she's going to share her experience and the new role that she's playing there. Okay, so before I turn it over to Tamishra, I believe Shomnath would like to speak a few words about her.
The stage is yours, Tamishra. Now please carry on. Thank you, Anunna, for the introduction.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks for the introduction. Hi, guys. My name is Tamishra Ray. I am a BPP IMD pass out. I passed out in the year 2018. Post that, I have 2 years of experience in consulting from Ernst & Young. And after that, I have joined IIM Lucknow as a PGP student. I'm currently in my first year. And in IIM Lucknow, I'm a part of Manifest Vajaswa, which is our annual sports and cultural fest. And today I'm here to introduce you to a few of the events that I'm hosting this year. So I'm the head of the vertical of music, literary events, as well as the Model United Nations. We have mainly joined this meet to talk about the Model United Nations. But other than that, I'm also hosting the music and literary events. So if any of you have interest in those events as well, you can connect with me. Other than that, the Model United Nations that I'm going to talk about today is one of the legacy events that IIM Lucknow has been hosting for the past 34 years. And we have, we get the best delegates from all over the country. Every year, students come and participate in this event on our campus. And this year, we are definitely missing that. But still, we are trying to replicate it over a Zoom platform, and we hope to get, you know, even better participation since the constraint of coming over here is not there. So since many people are not aware of how Model United Nations work, I'll just give a brief about how it works, and then we would go to the specifications of the competition as well. Students who are there in the meet today, many of them have already registered and they know about the event, and they are also meeting us for the meets that we had organizing on the weekends. We are having regular sessions where we are taking one-to-one sessions. We are also giving personal mentorship to the students who want it. And so about Model United Nations, I would like to begin with what is Model United Nations. In Model United Nations, it's a competition where we try to replicate the conferences of United Nations. So for this year, we have two committees in IIM Lucknow. The two committees are Lok Sabha and World Health Organization. And we would have two agendas for each of these two committees. For World Health Organization, our agenda is mitigation of COVID-19 pandemic. And for Lok Sabha, our agenda is abolition of middlemen in agricultural markets. So both these committees would be headed by a chairperson and a vice chairperson. And they would be the judges as well, and they would actually decide the format of the event. I'll tell you a generic format of the event that is followed in most of the MUNs. Many of you might have participated in MUNs in your school and college days, or like there's no bound to participation. We are having students from class 9 onwards till the age of 30. Anyone and everyone can participate. When you are participating in a Model United Nations, you as a participant, become the delegate of a particular conference. The judges would be the president and the vice president, and the delegates or the participants basically represent, in case of WHO, you would be representing different countries, and in case of Lok Sabha, you would be representing different political parties or different states, where you have to represent the state or the country you are a part of and accordingly speak on the agenda. I would take an example and try to explain it to you. Like if you are a part of the committee, World Health Organization, and you are discussing on the agenda mitigation of COVID-19 pandemic, your portfolio would have a country which you have to represent, and you would be given this portfolio 4 to 5 days before the competition. So you would have enough time to read about it and form your stance from the perspective that you are representing a particular country or a particular, you know, state in case of Lok Sabha. Once you are given the, you know, given your portfolio, you need to understand that whatever you will be speaking in a Model United Nations, it's not from your generic view, but from the stance of a particular country or state that you are a part of. The Model United Nations, how the format begins is at first the judges or the president or the vice president would tell you how exactly the format is going to be for the next 2 days. Yeah, so Model United Nations happens for 2 days. First day, it will be from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Second day also, it will be from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. It starts with a basic format introduction from the presidents. Moving on, they will have a general list where each of you would be asked to speak for a few minutes regarding the agenda and your basic stance from your countries or the portfolio you are representing, and you have to speak over there. Once that is done, the judges might, cross question, or there can be certain rebutting among yourself, like the participants, and then they move on to the second stage, which is a moderated caucus. In moderated caucus, what happens is they would the judges would be giving you sub agendas, like mitigation of COVID-19 pandemic is a broad agenda, right? There can be multiple things under this. There can be multiple discussions that can happen under this. So the judges would divide sub agendas, and they would be giving it to you, and you have to talk on, based on those sub agendas. Once the sub-agenda discussions are done, there would be certain, you know, again, certain rebutting, certain discussion. And once that would be over, you would be moving on to the third stage, which is your unmoderated caucus. In unmoderated caucus, you are supposed to discuss with other delegates in who it would be different country delegates. And Lok Sabha, as I already told you, it would be different state or political party delegates. You need to form allies with them. You need to find out who all, you know, whatever views you are putting in, who all are matching with those views, and accordingly you need to form allies with the delegates. Once you understand, you know, from where you can form the allies, you need to write a resolution paper where you would actually add whatever you have discussed in throughout the MUN, as well as the solutions that you think could be added for this particular discussion that you're having, like for the mitigation of COVID-19 pandemic, what exactly are the conclusions or solutions you are reaching to from the perspective of your country. You have to write those down. After everything is done, the resolution paper is submitted. The judges would be judging you based on your participation throughout these 2 days. And there is 60,000 rupees prizes worth up for grabs for you. Other than this, you would also receive goodies worth rupees 500. All the students will receive it, and also tickets to our cultural as well as pro shows, which is also worth 500 rupees. We have also made certain WhatsApp and Telegram channels where we are taking sessions every weekend. You'll get personalized mentorship from IIM Lucknow students, where you can ask any questions in those forums, from CAT preparation to MUN queries, to any kinds of doubts you are having. So these are the forums that we are running right now, and we are getting a lot of participation because many students, more than, you know, Model United Nation, also have a also have doubts regarding how to prepare for B-School interviews or in general personality development, sessions, whatever the questions are, we take up those questions as well. These channels are already ongoing, and you must have found those channels. If you have received the message for MUN participation, the channel joining links are also there. Hope you guys have already joined, and these are some of the things we are doing. And other than that, every year when we get participation on campus, the registration fees we charge is 1500 for this Model United Nations. This year, since it's online, we have reduced it to half of 750, and wherever we are getting, you know, bulk participation from any college, we are reducing it to even less, which becomes 600 or 500 depending on the number of people participating together. So if any of you are interested, do let me know. Sir would probably share the message for participation. We already have a lot of participation, and today we have also decided on the judges. We'll soon release the chairperson and the vice chairperson for World Health Organization, as well as the speaker and the deputy speaker for Lok Sabha. You can also check the credentials of the judges. They are the best in the country, and we hope to have a great Model United Nations this year. All the details will be shared with you, and if you still have any doubts, do connect with me and I'll clarify those doubts. So that's all about Model United Nations. Other than that, I would also like to talk about four of the other events that I'm hosting. Two music events I'm hosting. One is Sur, which is a solo singing competition. And the other one is Stairway to Hell, which is a band competition. All these competitions will be online and you need to submit video entries. So there's nothing like you have to travel, or there's no, you know, pressure on you to do anything. These events are for free. You can go ahead and register and send us the entries, and you have exciting prizes. For Sur, you have prizes worth ₹16,000. For Stairway to Hell, you have prizes worth ₹30,000 for grabs. And the two literary events I'm hosting is the Joust, which is a debate competition. And the other one I'm hosting is Rohan, which is a poetry competition. Here also you have to just send us the entries. There is no, you know, you don't have to travel or anything for the competition. You can send us the entries online. And these two are also free, of course. You can go ahead and participate. The prizes for the Joust include prizes worth ₹20,000. And for Rohan, it is prizes worth ₹16,000. So you can definitely go ahead and register. I would share the details in the group that Sir has made. And if any kinds of doubts you have, you can connect with me anytime. So if you have any doubts, we can take those right now. Otherwise, we can see if when you are interested, I can again come on and meet and we can discuss.
Thank you, Tamisha, Shreya, Shibran, a lot of things. First year they have joined. Suryans, welcome. And yes. Question, huh, Tamisha?
I think I gave enough information. And if people have any doubts, they can directly connect with me. My number is there. I am always available if you need any clarifications.
Yes. I think, thank you, Tamisha. And I think they can connect offline. Sir can be the mediator.
Exactly.
Information.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Great. Best wishes. So okay, one question. For your one stay question. And do well.
Shreya, you want to ask something?
Vishwadi, in the final round of Sur, will we have to submit video or there will be a live competition?
So you have to submit your final videos. For Sur, the judge is Anvesha, who is the winner of Star Voice of India, Chote Ustad, and she's our judge this year. She would be there on a Zoom link where we would be playing your final video submissions, and there the judging will happen live. But since, you know, we tried to have a live event, but there's a lot of unsecured, there's a lot of network issues that we were facing. So you would be sending us videos for final rounds as well. You'd be playing it live during the event where Anvesha would be joining, and there the judgment would be happening and the participants would also be there. You'll get your comments then and there.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks. Hi, Simran.
Hi. I was asking for the singing thing. So I was asking, the recordings that we have to send, can we put a background music, like if we are not playing it, or
so karaoke is, so if you go through the rule book, you'll see karaoke is as well as guitar, anything you want to use, you can use it. It's not mandatory, but if you want to use it, you can use it.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Questions, guys. Otherwise, I'll take a leave right now. And if you guys have any queries, connect with me directly, and I'll clarify them.
Thank you, Tamisha. At your own time, please help them to aptitude and technical.
I
don't forget your technical activities. I am proud of your technical.